Hi guys, welcome back to Sleeve Saturday. You know, the sound of Motown is iconic. I've always loved it. The songs this legendary label have released and produced never seem to age. Generation after generation enjoy them, which is a testament to the talent of the artists involved from the outset. The label was formed in Detroit in 1959 by Berry Gordy. Detroit of the 1950s was a factory town, particularly specializing in the automobile industry. Its citizens worked hard, but the town was also alive with culture and music. Berry, a former boxer and car factory worker himself, was a visionary for harnessing the potential of local talent. So with an $800 loan from his family, he created Motown Records, the label's name being a play on words of the main industry in the town of its birth. Gordy set up the new label's HQ in a small house and called it Hitsville, USA. It's from these humble beginnings that Motown grew. So many superstars came from and worked with this iconic record label. Diana Ross and the Supremes, Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, Stevie Wonder, Four Tops, Gladys Knight and the Pips, Commodores, Martha and the Vandellas, and of course, Marvin Gaye, amongst others. At a time of disgraceful segregation in the USA, the incredible music of Motown crossed the racial divide. It's music that touches the very fabric of your being, and as I said, it never dates. The fusion of rhythm and blues and soul is breathtaking. By 1963, the music of Motown was all over the airwaves and delivering hits. Between 1961 and 1971, they had clocked up a staggering 110 top 10 hits. So, with all that said, I thought I'd go back through the vast catalogue and pick out what for me is the label's 5 coolest singles. Let's take a look. Number 5, Four Tops, I Can't Help Myself, Sugar Pie Honey Bunch. Early on, Motown had in-house writers who also arranged a lot of its hits. This one, by the Four Tops from 1965, is one such song. I love lyrics like Sugar Pie Honey Bunch. It's just so earnest. The song was the biggest R&B hit for that year, and the lead vocal by Levi Stubbs is just class. Sonically, you have everything going on here. Motown is known for its bass guitar, but you also get some sax flavour and piano laced through it too. Just love it. Number 4, Stevie Wonder, Superstition. Very superstitious. Writings on the wall. Stevie released this as the first of 2 singles from his 1972 album, Talking Book. The opening riff, come on, it's so good. The instant you hear it, you're swaying from side to side or walking with a little skip. Penned and produced by Stevie, it's funk done to the highest standard it can be. And it was a number one hit. Stevie is one of the coolest people ever to live. And this song exudes cool. Number 3, Martha and the Vandellas, Dancing in the Street. In 1964, Motown released this one, which was co-written by Marvin Gaye. You think Motown? You think this song. Now, it has been overexposed at points through the year since its release in 1964, in medias such as movies, etc. But take a step back, close your eyes for a second, and just absorb Martha Reeves' vocal. Block out the sonics and just listen to how controlled she is. It's just so great. It's been covered a ton of times by everyone from Bowie and Jagger to Van Halen. Imitations, not a patch on the original. Number 2, The Temptations, My Girl. I've got sunshine. This has been a favourite of mine since childhood. It's one of those songs, isn't it, that's just always been there in your life. But for me, I never get tired of it. Once again, that Motown bassline is the spine through the song. There's nothing cynical here, no heartbreak, no regretful lyrics. It's just a song about a guy in love. I love lyrics like, I got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the month of May. It was co-written by another Motown powerhouse, Smokey Robinson, and when released in December 1964, it went on to the number one spot. Well, I guess you say what can make. Number 1, Marvin Gaye, What's Going On? Mother, mother, there's too many of you. Released from the album of the same name, this one from 1971 was at the top of my list before I even wrote the script for this video. Marvin. Man, he's the coolest of them all. The song's inspiration was initially drawn from a police brutality incident as witnessed by co-writer of the track, Ronaldo Benson, who was also a member of the Four Tops. Gay expanded the song's narrative to his own experiences, his observation of riots and racial injustice. He also drew from his brother Frankie's stories overseas during the Vietnam War. With all this going on, Marvin asked himself the question, with the world exploding around me, how am I supposed to keep singing love songs? This song perfectly nails his frustrations at the world around him. Such a beautiful track. What's going on? There you have my top 5 songs by the Motown label. And I'm curious, guys, what singles do you love by Motown? Let me know in the comments and don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed the video. I'll see you next time.